which is Korean noodles with that sweetened, meaty bean sauce that I think it's something where, like, if I wanted something more substantial than ramen, I would get jajangmyeon. And of course, we're doing a vegan version of it, which you totally cannot tell. And the recipe is so, so good, so I can't wait to show you guys the recipe. So let's head over to the kitchen and then let's get cooking.
Okay, so I'm gonna start off by making some wheat noodles, about 4 servings, prepared according to instruction, and then afterwards, strain it and run it under cold water so it doesn't get too sticky and it doesn't get overcooked. Next, we're gonna deal with the TVP. So half a cup of TVP with half a teaspoon of garlic powder to make it a little bit more meaty, and then just a little bit less than a half a cup of water. Just swish it around and then put it aside so that it has time to rehydrate. Afterwards, I'm gonna prepare my vegetables. So I have about 2 carrots. It's supposed to be 1 zucchini, but I didn't have it, so I used about 2 stalks of celery. But use some vegetables that are not too strong of a flavor, and then 1 whole potato that is diced, I would say, about like to 1/2 inch cubes, so that just to make sure that they're all the same size so that they cook kind of evenly. And then finally, half of an onion that I've julienned. You usually wanna cut it into chunks, but I like long strips. So medium to medium high heat pan, couple tablespoons of oil, and I put in the carrots first for about 3 to 4 minutes, just because they take a little longer to cook, and then afterwards I cook the rest of these guys for another 2 minutes. They will get cooked again later, but this is just to initially soften them. And you can actually see how many vegetables are going in. A lot of people think that jajangmyeon is just like this beany pasty sauce and that there's not a lot of vegetables in there, but there actually is, and you can control it as well. So after a couple of minutes, make a little well in the middle with about 1 to 2 tablespoons of oil, and then this is fermented bean paste. So this is the sweet Korean bean paste that will be flavoring a majority of your noodles. And what we're doing right now is we're putting in 1/4 cup of it in the center, and we are kind of fry it up medium to medium high heat. And I think that this is similar to kind of Indian food when you kind of fry up all of the spices. You're frying up this bean paste to kind of bring out additional flavors. Afterwards, just swish it around with all of the vegetables and make sure that all of the vegetables are coated. And then to that, add about 2 cups of water. Okay, so you're just mixing that around, make sure that everything is coated, put a cover on it, and then I'll bring it to a boil and simmer for about 10 minutes until the vegetables are softened. Meanwhile, you want to combine 2 tablespoons of cornstarch with about 1/4 cup of water, and this is what's going to thicken up your sauce at the end. So I've kind of brought up the heat a little bit more to a simmer, and then now I'm gonna put in my TVP, and kind of it takes about a minute or so for the TVP to soak up all of the flavor, but it really does so immediately. So after about a minute, just mix that around, make sure that everything is coated, and then you're gonna put in your cornstarch slurry, and then you're gonna bring this mixture back to a boil. So once it comes to a boil, you can see that it's nice and thickened up, and this is going to be your final sauce. I mean, you're basically all set here, and it looks nice and meaty, and it's sweet and savory at the same time, so it's really, really good. This is also the part where you wanna adjust the flavor. So maybe you wanna put in a little bit more salt. I put in actually a tad bit of sugar because I feel like it balances the flavor out just a little bit more. So afterwards, you have your wheat noodles here, a big scoop of that sauce, and then to top it off, you can top it off with vegetables. I topped it off with some sliced small pieces of scallions to make that look really nice. Anyways, there you guys have it, vegan jajangmyeon, a nice kind of hearty, meaty ragu that doesn't have the meat, and it really wasn't too hard to make, right? As usual, guys, if you like this recipe and you wanna see more of it, please hit like and subscribe, and yeah, swish it around, get all of the sauces covered, and I will see you guys again next time. Bye!